pump out huge amounts of debt issuance, which ultimately puts pressure on the central bank to essentially accommodate it in one form or the other, inflation takes hold. And what concerns me is, because it is unlikely to be a near-term phenomenon, indeed our forecast, is that the rate of inflation is going to fall into next year, into the early first and second quarter of next year. But then after, it begins to stabilize and gradually rises. The missing issue is, I do not have in that equation any what economists call anticipatory variables. Because people begin to anticipate what's going on out there, and that will begin to affect the yield on long-term interest rates, because a 30-year has a very substantial part of its value in 5 to 30 years out. So you begin to see it in areas of rising long-term interest rates and declining exchange rates. Now, I'm not overly concerned about the most recent decline in the dollar, for example, because remember, the dollar surged when the crisis began, as we still are conceived of as a safe haven. And we're now back to the levels of just prior to the crisis. So it's not as though we've come all the way down, but it's very difficult not to look out over the future and make the case for a strong dollar with the size of fiscal problems which remain to this day unattended to.
Now, some things seem to have happened in the last few years that at least I've never seen before. And what does that say to you? Does it suggest that maybe our models of the financial markets are got some flaws in them? And what do you take out of these series of unprecedented events that have taken place?
Yeah, Pete, I think that's why it is critical to make the judgment as to whether this is truly a once-in-a-century event, which is encompassed in the whole structure of risk management that has developed over the last 50 years, which has spawned innumerable Nobel Prizes, has been embraced by the academic community, and explains a goodly part of what goes on in the world. If this is truly, as I suspect it is, this once-in-a-century event, then we're essentially saying, yes, this is part of what we expect to happen. We expect it to happen extremely rarely. But events that happen extremely rarely do happen. And when you're living through them, it doesn't feel as though it's a 1 in 100 shot. It feels like it's 1 out of 1. And this means that a goodly part of our supervisory regulatory debate is not quite focused, and truly it's very difficult to focus, on whether this is a major breakdown in the financial system. Well, first of all, let me say it is a breakdown. The question is that conventional historic theory always expects that there will be periodic breakdowns because no risk management model covers all conceivable possibilities with capital. But you can use that as that's the standard lingo that everyone would use all the time, but it means something. And you've got to make, before you decide to make major changes in the system, you've got to answer the question, is this something which is rare but not out of the concept of conventional wisdom, so to speak, or are we actually looking at a change in the way the system fundamentally functions?
Well, let me be sure I understand. What's your conclusion on that question?
Well, my conclusion basically is, I think it's not an aberration. I think it's an extremely rare event, but economics is an imprecise science, and we often look back on events which made no sense at the time and recognize that there were seminal changes which altered our way of thinking. I don't think that is true, but I can't rule out the possibility, knowing that all economics indeed all of the social sciences, or to a large extent, basically probabilistic and not as exact as we would like them.